on the move.
Ken's Bering Sea rival is working flat out.
When the tide's out, you move deeper.
After getting off to a late start, Captain Shawn Pomrenke is looking to capitalize on a gift from Mother Nature, a swathe of potentially rich ground uncovered by the shifting sea floor.
We're gonna go to ground we can't usually reach.
And now suddenly reachable at low tide.
My main focus right now is to get as much gold as I can, keep this plant running.
With the 2,000-ounce gold needed to pay off his debts and end the season in the black, he's still facing an uphill battle.
Come on, baby.
To get the debt paid off and get back to work on the mega dredge, if I'm gonna make any profit at all, I gotta pull in over $1.3 million this year.
Right now, I'm seeing what kind of reach I can get. And if the tide's out far enough to go out past where we've been.
The tide is on Shawn's side, but the clock's ticking, as high waters will return in less than 6 hours.
Diggy, diggy.
Was the first time I dove on the Tomcod. There's nobody else in Nome that knows that ground better than I do. But with everything changing, it's like starting all over again.
Sometimes it hides in the gravel, sometimes it hides on the clay, sometimes it's under the clay. It's like a really fun game of hide and seek. Where are you hiding? I was always good at hide and seek. I like to win. Not a whole lot of heavies. A couple of small specks. We gotta get a different sample, maybe a little deeper.
The perfect spot is still eluding him. If he doesn't find pay dirt soon, Shawn will be out of his depth.
That stuff was a little loose, a little light. But 5 feet over this way and 5 feet over that way, we could be right next to 1,000 ounces and not even know it. It's here somewhere. We just gotta keep taking big chunks of ground out. Getting better. This is feeling like a good sample here. There should be some gold in there. But I've said that before. And it has the smell. It smells like money. Yeah. Where are you hiding? Sometimes you gotta just look for it a little bit harder.
Ooh! Oh, I see you already.
There you go. That's some chunkier stuff there. That's what I was looking for. You're not that good at hide and seek. Let's fire up. Let's start putting some dirt through it. We're gonna dig until tide comes back in. Show Ken, what's up? Oh yeah!
A quarry of boulders is a notorious hiding spot for gold.
They work just like ripples in the sluice box. You have the wave actions, taking the water and the gold and picking it up and throwing it. And then as it washes back and the tide recedes,
it hides and comes in and gets stuck in all these big rocks. And right underneath those boulders is really good-looking material.
I love digging in the big boulders because there's always a lot of gold.
Oh, almost.
But you put too big of a boulder through that wash plant, it'll destroy that thing.
Clearing the massive rocks takes time Shawn doesn't have. But there's no choice if he wants to reach the gold beneath. Before the rising tide closes in.
That's why this gold's still here. It is hard digging. Is that it? That's what I was looking for. I just found some really nice gravel. It's hot. I've gone from diving to digging with the excavator, and now I'm going to build the machine I need to build to come out here and mop all this gold up. We're going to come around and kick Ken's ass in a hurry.
The arrival of high tide shuts down mining.
We're gonna check the test mat. Hopefully a big payday.
So the limited time he had needs to pay off big to make it all worth it.
Ooh. Ooh. Oh, yeah.
See a good solid gold all across here. That's what I'm talking about. Maybe we'll pull this season up. Oh, yeah! Ocean kind of threw us a curveball there.
At the Pomrenke compound.
Went under the deep sand, got into big boulders, boulder after boulder after boulder. Hopefully there's some big gold under there.
Shawn dug deep while the tide was low, pursuing a pay streak among a pit of ancient boulders. Now, he's ready to see what he's earned.
We had to chase it down a little bit, but now I think we're on the right track.
Really clean.
Boom, here we go. Let's see what we got. Feeling good. I am ready to rumble with the Bering Sea.
127 ounces is worth over $190,000.
Right around 250 ounces in the last couple weeks of mining. Not bad. Life's good. This gives me hope that I'll kick Ken's ass and reclaim the crown. We need to claw our way back to the top.
Bada boom, bada bing.
Coming for you, Ken. A little bit every day.
Hot on Ken Kerr's heels, Shawn moves closer to regaining the top spot.